Before we start the video, make sure to subscribe to my channel. I appreciate all the support I receive from you. And as always, all the information in my videos is rumors taken from the internet or the street. I'm not saying the information is fact.
Don't pick your mans up.
Yeah, that's because people used to come through shooting us every day. Yeah, this block, words can't even explain. Can't even explain.
Hey, man.
Little school rally on 5-1, Young Money.
Young Money, man. They in the building.
600 boy, LA, man. LA Capone, man. Get in tune, man. OC2 hey. Boys, man.
Team Rondo, number 9, man. Number 9, the shooter, you hear me?
Hey, we did
You have to be willing to die or go to jail for 100 years if that's the lane that you're stepping in. You have to understand that whether you're 15, 16, you got to think like a man. You know what I'm saying? Like,
so don't be in it. Oh, you're not? Why does everybody say you're only 16 years old?
They say what they want to say.
How old
so
are
how old are you?
300.
The story of T.Roy.
A motherfucker run up on me, I will shoot you. No problem. I will fucking shoot you. Yes, I will. So if you see me, it ain't no shit, leave me the fuck alone.
This is one of the most requested videos from my viewers, the story of T.Roy from O'Block, perhaps the most infamous non-rapping gang member from Chicago during the 2010s, a face and a name that everyone who follows the Chicago drill scene recognizes. Why T.Roy became so famous has several reasons. Partly it was for the work he put in. However, there were other members around Chicago who put in as much or more work as him. What made T.Roy so famous was because rappers like Boss Top and Chief Keef mentioned him in songs, and because of the consequences after T.Roy was murdered. His name became infamous over Chicago after being referred to as a shooter and killer in many songs, just like D-Rose. Not to forget when his best friend, King Von, beat his murder case, got out, started rapping, and spread T.Roy's name across the world to honor him, and even adopted his nickname to his own name, V-Roy. T.Roy and V-Roy were one of the most notorious killers in Chicago with over 20 bodies between them. This is the story of T.Roy. T.Roy, whose real name was James Johnson, was born on October 30th, 1993 in Chicago, Illinois. Unlike many other of O'Block's infamous members such as Boss Top, BJ, Big A, King Von, Cheno and many others, T.Roy and his brothers grew up in Parkway Gardens with his mother, father, brothers and cousins. T.Roy had two brothers, one older and one younger, Slutty and HK, both shot and killed, HK in 2017 and Slutty in 2020. Shirley did not only raise her sons, she also took care of their cousins, Zelmana, Eli and Mario from Parkway Gardens, some even mistaken them for being T.Roy's brothers. I cannot imagine how much pain Shirley and other mothers around Chicago go through every day in mourning for their lost sons. Shirley has now lost her three sons, Slutty, HK, Slutty and their cousin Zelmana who took his own life in August this year. T.Roy also had a sister who I will leave unnamed. T.Roy also had cousins outside of O Block around Chicago. Among others, he was a cousin of Drills from Eastbot, Big Talk from Black Mob, and Nutso from Lakeside. Those of you who have seen the story of Mad Max know that Nutso from Lakeside, whose real name was Larry Pickens, was shot and killed in mid-June 2008, allegedly by G. Fazo from No Limit Muskegon Boys. In fact, Nutso had a history in Parkway Gardens and even claimed Wick City as well. The whole T.Roy's family was deeply rooted in Parkway Gardens. He had uncles who were OGs in Parkway Gardens before it was even called Wick City back in the 90s. A lot of the BDs who moved into Parkway Gardens during the early 90s were from Newtown on 39th and were uncles and cousins of T.Roy. Big Talk from Black Mob, who was one of T.Roy's cousins, was the son of Tokyo G, who was an OG from Parkway Gardens, and one of those who moved in from Newtown. Tokyo G was the uncle to T.Roy and the rest of his brothers, but also his cousins and an old Wick City member named Freak, who was the younger brother of Nutso from Lakeside. Freak was released from jail in 2019 after serving 10 and a half years in jail. Tokyo G was killed on September 23, 1996. His cousin Johnny, also from Parkway Gardens, was also killed around that time. T.Roy also had other cousins from Wick City, among others, Johnny, Sharona, and Timo, all alive. T.Roy's uncle, Tokyo G, is actually been said to have been the first body dropped between Boss City, which today is more known as STL, Dog Pound, today more known as Wick City, even though Dog Pound is still around, but back then, nearly everything was Dog Pound. However, what effect this murder had or the motive to it is unknown since it's so far back in time, but most likely it have something to do with drug territory. As you all know, it is usually in school that most members get into the criminal path. We have seen that pattern through all my videos, and that was also the case with T.Roy. It is at school that you meet other young people from other areas of the city, which often can end in fights that then lead to shootings and murders. In high school, T.Roy attended the Diet Academic Center, where several well-known names also attended. Among others, Chief Keef also attended Diet. In Diet, before Chief Keef's name spread around the world, he pretty much ran Diet. Back then, he was already infamous in Chicago. He used to walk around in school rapping. All the girls came trailing behind him. Because of this, along with Chief Keef hanging with a few of DHF 46's main members like Rome, Slushy, and Black, resulted in members of rival gangs really hating him. Since all gangs are linked to each other, not only DHF's enemies hated him, but also STL, Jaro, and Ma, due to the fact that O Block and 600 being close with THF, combined with the fact that Keef was actually coming from Parkway. Keef was also talking a lot of shit in school. There were several times when he walked around with DHF and got into it with 051 members. There were also one time in Diet where the school gathered in the gym for a lecture. When the whole gym was quiet, Chief Keef shouted, "F Zico." Lil Mick from 051 Young Money was once jumped by Nino, Quono, Chief Keef, M Thang, Lil Ant, and Just Blow. Another fun fact is that T.Roy used to dance a lot in Diet.
Hey, I'm gonna get a little. All right, my friend. Money, dude, kidnap your children. I don't wear the war one coming where you living. Drug gauge knocking nigga body through the ceiling. Dre heads and tattoos, that's how my squad living. Skinny jeans jerked out, that's how this nigga feeling. Ass kinda low, cause I'm high in the ceiling. And I'm in the truck, so we stay in the building. Yeah. Like a church song.
Yeah.
Since T.Roy is 2 years older than Chief Keef, he was a junior when Chief Keef was a freshman. They hung out a bit at school, however, T.Roy did not go around with DHF and Mock Dead 051 members. He hung out more around Wick City and 600 members and got into it with Jaro and STL members. Don't get me wrong, T.Roy still hung out with DHF a lot, but he didn't go around shouting FZK like Keef. The reason why T.Roy did not go around mocking dead 051 members was because he was actually cool with Aero from 051. They were not only cordial with each other, but they really hung out with each other, smoked together and whatnot. Even when the beef between O Block and 051 escalated, much thanks to Brubra and their war with 600, T.Roy and Aero still hung out with each other. Aero even came to Parkway Gardens several times. One time, in October 2012, Aero even asked T.Roy if he needed to be armed when he was coming to O Block, and T.Roy replied, "Hell no, you good bro, you're going to be with me." This also shows how much respect T.Roy already had in 2012, that he could bring a member from 051 to O Block without Aero getting touched. However, once the war got even worse in 2013 to 2014, especially after Lil Mark was killed, T.Roy started mocking 051 more and he and Aero met less. In Diet, T.Roy, Ball Out and Lil Ant from Front Street often used to fight members from STL, Jaro and Mob. However, T.Roy was a very small and short dude. He was around 5 feet 2 inches and 130 pounds, so he did not really stand a chance in a lot of fights, even if he surely won several fights. But he never backed down. He always stood 10 toes. He really had a heart of a lion. Later, however, he stopped fighting and started shooting. He even wrote on Twitter, "I do not fight, I'm too little, think about that," which pretty much implies that he will shoot to kill. In the years around 2005 to 2007, the first criminal activities began in Parkway Gardens. However, it was only a loose group of friends. The block had no identity at all. Parkway was neither BD nor GD at that time. Around the years before Parkway Gardens got an identity, there were GDs, BDs and even Black B-Stones from the East Side and Mickey Cobras from the low end in the territory. The area at the time used to be so quiet that guys even used to post up outside of the gates and in front of stores in the area, because they were not involved in any serious conflicts. Parkway Gardens started changing in 2007 to 2009 when Boss Top, Spike, BJ and Bigga moved in from No Love City, and King Von from Killer Ward. Around 2009 was the time T.Roy and King Von first met each other. However, their friendship did not become as we know it today immediately. It was not until around 2011, but especially in 2012, they became very close after catching bodies and shooting people together. In January 2011, T.Roy even wrote "Free King Von, Wick City Shawty" on his old Twitter. Such incidents, catching bodies together, create an indescribable bond between two people, and I guess they also had chemistry between each other that was unbreakable. You know, when you meet a person, you notice immediately if the chemistry between you will suit. Both had a heart like a lion, showed no mercy towards the enemies, both wanted to win and both saw themselves as untouchable and invincible kings in the streets. They were the most feared members from O Block. They held it down for the Wick, and the fact is that when T.Roy and King Von were locked up, STL slash EBT and Jaro seized the opportunity and started dropping people from the O. However, when King Von and T.Roy were out in the free world, the tables turned, and people from other sides started to drop. Around Around 2009 to 2010, when more and more BDs started moving into Parkway Gardens, they had to come up with an identity. They came up with Wild, Insane, Crazy, and then added City because it was a trend back then, just like Jaro named their set Jaro City. They later added three I's to throw in a trace in the name, so it became known that it was a BD area now. This was at the same time as STL was formed. Back in 2009 to 2010, when STL/EBT and Wick City started beefing, it usually only ended up with fights with guys from the different sides. STL and EBT used to come to Parkway, jumping over the fences, looking for other shorties to fight with. When Wooski, Tuka, Duck and other STL and EBT members came to Wick City more frequently, the older ones started handing out guns to the younger Wick City members. This is the main reason why people like T.Roy, King Von and Chief Keef jumped off the porch and started playing with guns. You see, back then it was lame for a member in his 20s to kill a 13 or 14 year old boy. It didn't matter what they did. The older Wick City members could not accept that people could just march into their territory, so instead of doing something themselves, D-Hay put guns in the younger guys' hands instead. Next time STL/EBT and Jaro members came to fight, T.Roy and other Wick City shorties let off shots. Just as I mentioned at the beginning, T.Roy had two brothers, one younger and one older, Slutty and HK. However, neither of them had the same father. HK's last name was Murray and Slutty's was Blakely. Both brothers died because of their unwavering loyalty to O'Block. Slutty died protecting his brothers from O'Block that dark night when King Von lost his life and career. HK died after killing damn near everyone involved in the murder of his big brother, T.Roy. What many do not know is that T.Roy tried for a long time to keep HK away from that life, and HK was not really interested in it either, at least not to shoot and kill. Do not get me wrong, HK hung around all O'Block members and can be seen in several music videos from 2012 onwards. However, after his big brother's death, O'Block in some ways pressured him to turn up for his brother, which he did. He wiped out his killer's best friend, and the one who gave out T.Roy's location, DB, Poppy and Brick. T.Roy's older brother, Slutty, was an older member and one of the originals from Wick City. However, Slutty originated from Ada Park, which is the same area that King Von's father Silk came from, ruled and later died in. It was not until Slutty actually died that people found out who he was and that he was the brother of T.Roy. He was not particularly famous before that, despite having often been in pictures with his brothers, Lil Durk and several other O'Block members. Slutty lost his life to protect King Von. It's hard to watch the video, but seconds after Lil Tim shot King Von in the back, Slutty and BJ shot him in the leg. When Slutty was about to finish the job, his gun jammed, and you can clearly see on the video that he tries to shoot Tim several times and even went closer to him and stood over him, but the gun did not work. Everything went wrong for O'Block that night. It really was King Von's time to go. What I've heard and what O'Block members have also confirmed is that Slutty was a real demon, a shooter and killer, which is not so surprising when you see how he shot Lil Tim in a flash after King Von was shot. He reacted immediately. He has been arrested over a dozen times, including for a gun crime in 2016. Just like I mentioned earlier, T.Roy started playing with guns around the years 2009 to 2011 after the older Wick City members handed out guns to the shorties. In high school, Chief Keef got into it a lot with a Jaro City member called Tell. They had several fights with each other. Once Chief Keef crossed the border with him and said FOJ to his face. OJ was a Jaro City / Del Mob member who was shot and killed along with Lil D from Met Boys in 2010. Allegedly by Poopoo from SMG and Face from TYMB. Both were kidnapped, stripped naked, then shot and killed and left lying on a train track near 90th and South Holland. Both OJ and Lil D were only 17 years old. Because of Keef mocking OJ, Del Mob and Tell tried to jump Chief Keef, but T.Roy came and let off shots towards Tell and the others, defending Chief Keef. T.Roy defended Keef several times in Diet when he got into it with Mob and Jaro City members. He once let off shots towards Juju from Mob together with Keef. This is why Chief Keef has always been showing love to T.Roy and stood by his side, even after he fell out with O'Block. Keef has mentioned T.Roy in several of his songs and T.Roy is featured in many of his music videos. Like I said, in 2011, T.Roy started shooting at people, robbing, hitting licks and whatnot. T.Roy often used to come through shooting up Jaro City at guys like Flash, Rock, Santana, Bud, Number 9 and several other Jaro and STL/EBT members. However, T.Roy had not started killing people yet. However, that would change in 2012 once King Von came out of jail in March 2012 for the armed robbery in early 2011. After the murder of OD in August 2011, after the murder of Patoon in October 2011 and after the murder of Sheroid in February 2012, King Von and T.Roy were out for blood. King Von even mentioned in the song Don't Wanna Be Me, where he said, I done did my time, I'm chilling, 2012 if you wanna be specific. Alasta and Patoon, that killed me, see, that's change in the plans now, all that shit I said in jail ain't the plan now, gotta get my hands dirty, pull that mask out, get caught by King Von, boy you asked out. OD, Patoon and Sheriot were three very important front figures for Wick City. With OD coming from Buff City and already had his own guns, he had already got shot at, hitting licks and shooting at people. He once blew at Gotti from Ragtown after they came through blowing at Buff City. He taught several younger Wick City members how to slide and rob people. King Von even said in his song Pull Up featuring Asian Doll, Oh told me when I go sliding show no mercy. King Von also mentioned Patoon's meaning in an unreleased song where he rapped, In confused cause JR he a leader, how the fuck you gun die on us, Oh just died we need you. There were really three incredibly important members for Wick City. OD was killed by STL/EBT and Mob. There have been so many names mentioned like KI, Butta, Boss Trell, Scrap and Beans. We will probably never find out exactly who killed him as the truth is buried with lies and police documents. Patoon was allegedly killed by Lil B, and Sheroid by Boss Trell. After outstanding members like OD, Fatoon and Sheroid fell in the war, it was natural for other members to take their place as outstanding members and take revenge on their behalf. The two members who would take over and put the pressure back on Jaro City and STL/EBT were none other than T.Roy and King Von. Both became two monsters out on the streets, their reputation grew and they became the most feared members from O'Block. Both started catching body after body and they never stopped. Some Jaro and STL members even stayed inside because of them. Cash even said it himself once King Von died. Swipper, who was a hangaround from that area and was actually around the members, even said that STL and FBG referred to King Von as a serial killer. Just 2 months after the murder of Sheroid, T.Roy and King Von would have caught their first body together and to my knowledge, their first body to their count.
Yeah, Young South. He wasn't saying nothing when Von was here. He wasn't saying nothing. And I'm on the side where they at. All of them was scared of Von. On my mama. All of them was scared of Von. On some real shit. They was calling them, they labeled the man a serial killer. Them niggas. Man, a serial killer. I'm like, who y'all talking about serial? Oh, Von. Just say Von then, nigga. The fuck y'all saying serial killer like y'all scared, nigga.
On April 28th, 2012, T.Roy and King Von began their murder spree. King Von, T.Roy, OJ from Larman and M Thang were out for revenge after the murder of their close friend Sheroid. They were not looking for any particular member of STL/EBT, the one they saw, that person's life would be taken. They were out riding around in a dark green Chevrolet Impala on STL's main block, 63rd and St. Lawrence. Marlon Monroe, also known as King Doc, had just been at his aunt's house and painted. After a few hours of painting, he became thirsty and decided to go to a nearby convenience store to buy something to drink, but he would never have time to enter the store and buy his drink. King Von, T.Roy, OJ and M Thang spotted him on his way to the store. Marlon saw them and tried to run, but either Von or T.Roy hopped out the vehicle and started letting off shots with a 380 caliber semi-automatic pistol. The bullets caught up to him and Doc was struck once in the chest. Doc stumbled and fell into a patch of tall weeds in an empty lot that adjoins the corner shop. The police came to investigate the April 28th shooting, cleaned up the scene and took off, his family said. It was not until hours later that Monroe's body was discovered in the tall weeds. A 16-year-old relative who was in a rush trying to make curfew was crossing through the abandoned lot when he found King Doc's lifeless corpse in the 6300 block of South St. Lawrence Avenue. When he was found, he was rushed to John H. Stroger, Jr. Hospital of Cook County, where he was pronounced dead at 10:14 p.m. Marlon had just returned to the free world after being imprisoned for stealing a car. He got out on parole 2 months before he was killed. Before his death, Marlon was trying to get a painter's license and had been doing maintenance for property owned by his aunt. He had received a GED while in prison, his family said. After his jail stint, Monroe had been trying to tell younger relatives to avoid a life of crime. He was showing his little brother the path he needed to take, said his aunt Deborah Jackson, adding that Monroe had been looking for a steady job. He said he was ready, he did not want to be in that situation no more, Jackson said. Marlon was described as gentle and kind-hearted, he was not in a gang, family members said. The 16-year-old boy who found Marlon was none other than Modell McCambry, who was a cousin of Marlon and whom we will come to later in the story. Modell was cutting through the store parking lot when he stumbled over the body. He ran to tell people that he had found a dead body, and when the police came and turned the body over, Modell saw it was his cousin Marlon Monroe. The two teens came from a large family that is known by most folks on the block because they had lived there for a long time through generations. Florine and John Monroe, the grandparents of Modell, Marlon and also Miles Turner, had raised six girls in their home in the 6500 block of South Roads. In the course of more than 30 years, they also raised several of their nearly 40 grandchildren and great-grandchildren in that home. Modell was devastated after the death of his cousin and therefore started to get more involved in the criminal life. He started to hang around people like K.I., Duck and Boss Trell and was soon a member of the gang STL/EBT. The murder of Marlon was a nightmare for the grandparents Florine and John, but a few months later the nightmare would worsen further. Unlike King Von, T.Roy was already taken seriously at this point. He had already shot people from Jaro and STL. The murder of Doc only made his reputation grow even more. People from Jaro, STL and even 051 Young Money were already talking about T.Roy and knew what he was about. His name rang bells and his enemies knew it. T.Roy continued to slide with King Von and other O-Block members like Hedog the rest of the spring and throughout the summer. In early August 2012, T.Roy was present at a murder that just 20 hours later would lead to the murder of White White from O'Block. I'm talking about the murder of Dirty Rel from Jaro City, which would later lead to the murder of White White from O'Block just 20 hours later. On the 8th of August 2012, a day before King Von's birthday, T.Roy, King Von, D. Rose and C. Murder were out in traffic on East 56th Street in the Washington Park neighborhood, which is approximately a 5-minute drive from Parkway Gardens. T.Roy, Von, Manny and D. Rose were not out looking for someone special but just rode around smoking and listening to music. But as always when you are out sliding like this, you are prepared because just like King Von said in an interview, the day you ain't looking for him, you're going to walk into him and you will not have your mask and will not be ready. T.Roy and Von could some days be out in the traffic for over 4 hours, just riding around, smoking and listening to music, but they made sure they and the boys they rode with were always ready. They had their guns and had their masks in case they would unexpectedly bump into an enemy where they did not think they would see him. Anyways, back to the incident. T.Roy and the others saw Dirty Rel walking on the sidewalk. One of them pulled out their gun and shot him with multiple shots, with one bullet striking him in the chest, two in the back, one to his right side. Who it was that actually pulled the trigger is hard to know. According to rumors I have heard, it was C. Murda and T.Roy. Dirty Rel, whose real name was Daryl Joshua, was taken to John H. Stroger Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. Dirty Rel was an older member from Jaro City. According to the police, Terrell had passed gang ties but that he had left that life behind him and moved to Peoria. The police said it is unclear why Josuha was in Chicago on this day. The retaliation would come soon after the murder of Dirty Rel. Both Jaro and STL got hurt after the murder of Rel, Wooski from STL/EBT and 50 Shots from Jaro City, who was really close friends and were the two who really held Jaro City and STL/EBT together, decided to go to Parkway to try to retaliate immediately on O'Block. Usually, when the other side tries to retaliate this fast, it's without success or they succeed but someone gets caught and has to spend the rest of their life in jail. This is because the police, in most cases, directly received the information about which gang was involved in the murder and are therefore prepared in case a quick retaliation would come against the block that was involved in the murder. In this case, police knew about O Block's involvement in the murder of Dirty Rel, just like they knew after the murder of FBG Duck. Therefore, they decided to post up with cars and officers around Parkway Gardens, just like after the murder of Duck. Wooski and 50 Shots knew about this but decided to take the risk anyway. They went to East 63rd Street and South Martin Luther King Drive and spotted White Wide outside of a store. King Von was with him and had just bought him a pill of some sort. Then Von went into the store, and when Von was in the store, 50 Shots and Wooski took the opportunity to score. They walked up to him and 50 Shots shot him in his chest once. But what they did not know was that police officers were patrolling exactly that street. The police officers saw when 50 Shots shot White Wide in the chest, and when they came to the scene, 50 Shots started to shoot at the officers without hitting any of them. However, the officers returned fire and shot 50 Shots in his leg, but the two still managed to flee the scene. It was all over in a couple of seconds. The police could soon after the shooting arrest 50 Shots, and he was charged 3 days later with first-degree murder and 2 counts of attempted murders. 50 Shots, whose real name is Darren Williams, is still held in the county to this day without bail. He hasn't actually been convicted yet. Truth to be told, the odds of Darren being released isn't high if it's true that the police officers saw him shooting White White. The strange thing is that he has been sitting for 8 years now without having been convicted for it, despite the fact that the evidence against him is so strong. Either way, I do not think he will get out anytime soon. Just like with King Von after the assassination of White White, T.Roy became a demon in the streets. He started to get really active and literally started wilding out on his enemies, and this after already doing a lot of dirt the first half of the year. The thing is that T.Roy and King Von were very similar and had one thing in common: they wanted to win. Many members were born into the game without a choice and do everything just to survive. However, T.Roy and Von wanted something else. They wanted to win the game. Just 2 months later, in late September, T.Roy was locked up for shooting FBG Young in the leg. Swipper, who, yet again, was a hangaround from that area, even said that FBG Young snitched on T.Roy at the hospital. However, I have a hard time believing it, since Young still has a lot of respect, and Swipper had an agenda towards Young. However, Young actually admitted in the DMs with Swipper that T.Roy did in fact shoot him, but that he is dead now. Meanwhile, T.Roy was locked up. King Von tweeted, "My boy T.Roy in the jam, now who the F I'm supposed to drill with?" However, Von did not have to wait long for his right hand to come out into the free world again. T.Roy was released after just a few days and was out on the streets again with King Von, to cause as much damage and grief as possible before he was locked up again. In September 2012, an altercation occurred between King Von and K.I. which sparked their personal beef and their infamous fake relationship that Von built up between them. It was after this altercation that Von's infatuation with her really began. The altercation took place on the train. King Von and other members from O Block spotted K.I. on the train and beat her up badly. They then left her on the train, and King Von wasted no time and went straight to Twitter to mock Jakira, where he said, among other things, that he should have spit on her after he finished up beating her. Von followed up this incident by shooting up St. Lawrence and Jaro City twice in the same week. However, just a week later, Jakira would take revenge by trying to kill both King Von and T.Roy, without success. This incident was one of two actual reasons that led to the murder of Modell from STL/EBT. The first reason, or rather rumor, as most people know, is that King Von allegedly got beaten up by Modell. Whether it is true or not, I don't know. The second reason, the more unknown, is that T.Roy and King Von, 3 days before the murder of Modell, was shot by none other than K.I. herself. K.I., FBG Cash were out sliding and spotted King Von and T.Roy outside the gates of Parkway Gardens. Both K.I. and Cash started letting off shots. Von got hit with one or two bullets to his leg which grazed him. The three managed to escape and ran into Parkway again and went into one of their apartments. Von and T.Roy got away with a hair's breadth, in case K.I. and Cash had done a walk up instead of shooting from inside a car. It would probably have been over for either Von or T.Roy. A few hours after the incident, both Von and T.Roy made it very clear who shot at them. Von tweeted, LOL, a leg shot, then what? And, I ain't no lame, I gotta get shot in my leg for us to be cool, that's crazy. T.Roy made it even clearer a few hours after the shooting took place when he tweeted, I'm going to kill this girl. This incident is the main reason why Von and T.Roy were so thirsty for revenge. 3 days later, it came. October 13, 2012, T.Roy and King Von got their revenge on STL/EBT, specifically on Wooski and K.I. who were constantly coming through shooting up a block. L.A. Capone, T.Roy, King Von and Jay Money were casually out looking for enemies on the 6300 block of South Rhodes Avenue around 9:30 p.m. At the same time, Miles, a cousin of Modell, was standing on a porch on the same street talking to a girl when Modell and close friend Richie Jerk came by. In the same second, L.A. Capone, King Von, T.Roy and Jay Money stepped out of a gangway. Von and T.Roy walked up to Modell and put multiple shots in his chest. Modell collapsed on the street and Richie Jerk started running as shots from T.Roy and King Von came towards him. Luckily, he managed to escape the situation. When Miles saw Modell collapsing on the street, he ran towards him and bent over to embrace him, which he never should have done. Because tragically, Von and T.Roy weren't planning on leaving any witness, and shot Miles over 5 times in his back. T.Roy and the others left Miles and Modell bleeding on the street and fled the scene on foot and went back to Parkway Gardens. The girl Miles was talking to called the police and paramedics. The two teens were found on the street and were both taken to the hospital. Modell to Stroger Hospital and Miles to Northwestern Memorial Hospital, both in critical condition. Modell was tragically pronounced dead at the hospital. Miles, on the other hand, miraculously and luckily survived.
didn't work.
Period. They said I've been on since 2014, baby. Not bottling bitches up.
Man, you think that's wrong? You beating up somebody? You know how many motherfuckers we beat up? Tell her, Lord.
You lost one fight before.
I swear to God, and I popped that person.
I lost one fight before.
Nah, you ain't popped that person, though.
Miles was so gravely wounded that after one surgery, doctors told his father the youth's intestines fell through their hands when they picked him up. He remained in a medically induced coma for weeks. Around Christmas, Miles was moved to a specialty wound center, and then to the Rehabilitation Institute of Chicago before going home in May. Teachers from Leo Catholic High School tutored him so he could keep up with his education, and he graduated June 2, 2013. Adjustment to the physical changes in his life has been difficult for Miles. The former high school football player has a catheter and needs a wheelchair to move around. It's important to know that Miles was just an innocent bystander who simply was in the wrong place at the wrong time. He had nothing to do with the beef between STL/EBT and O-Block. According to Miles' father, Modell was a gang wannabe, but that Miles, his own son, had no interest in the criminal life. In the incident report from the murder of Modell and the attempted murder of Miles, no suspects are mentioned by name. However, one suspect had a description. The witness described one of the offenders as 5 feet 2 inches tall and a weight of 145 pounds, which matches T.Roy. This, combined with several incriminating tweets from T.Roy, basically confirms that T.Roy was one of the killers along with King Von. Although there was only one suspect in the police report, EBT Greg confirmed that there were 2 killers. STL members like Billionaire Black confirmed the day King Von died that he was one of the killers. There may be several reasons why there were not 2 suspects in the police report. It was dark outside, Miles was in a coma for weeks, and it is not certain that the witness saw everything. After the murder, T.Roy tweeted things like, "It raindrops because some op is DOA like JoJo," and "No lacking home." King Von tweeted things like, "Me and T.Roy, man, we murder for fun," and "Me and T.Roy got a problem, we just cannot stop doing our thingy thang," and all that. As you probably notice, very much of T.Roy's story is similar to King Von's story so far in the video, which is not strange. They had now caught 2 bodies together. However, much of the work T.Roy put in happened in 2013 when King Von was locked up, which we will come to later in the story. Modell, who King Von and T.Roy shot to death, was very close to K.I., which resulted in K.I. went after both Von and T.Roy to try to get revenge immediately after the murder of Modell. However, it was difficult to find them. Either they were in someone's apartment in either O Block or 600's territory, or they were already out in cars riding around dangerous, which makes it very difficult to catch your enemy, especially when they are armed. Instead, Jakira decided to go after T-Roy's two cousins, Sharona and Travis, who I suspect were involved in fights with other girls from Jaro and STL/EBT. Just 2 days after the murder of Modell, K.I. came blowing at both Sharona and Travis at the AutoZone outside of O Block. Fortunately, none of the bullets hit. However, K.I. actually got locked up for this as Travis and Sharona snitched on her, and even pointed her out in a lineup at the police station. However, K.I. was released by court after 1 week, but on certain conditions. When K.I. was released, she even wrote to King Bun on Twitter, and said he should tell Sharona and Travis to stop snitching, and to not come to court. K.I. also tweeted about O Block talking about her getting out and that they were scared. K.I. and Wooski were actually two of the few who actually cared about Modell in the aspect that they slid for them and actually tried to get revenge. Many even blamed STL for the death of both Modell and Dale, since they were not really about that life but were more hangarounds. Booby from Jaro City even tweeted about this and said that STL was fake for not sliding for Modell, which K.I. and Booby came into a dispute over since K.I. actually did slide for Modell. K.I. and other STL members like Dutchie have also said that Modell and Dale were not really with it and were just innocent bystanders. Dale was killed by D. Rose in December 2011. Just 6 days later after K.I. tried to kill T.Roy's two cousins, T.Roy and King Bun took revenge on Jaro City, on two members that Jakira was very close to. On October 21, 2012, T.Roy and King Bun were out lurking on roads and decided to shoot up Jaro City on the 6200 block of South Rhodes Avenue. They spotted both Lil Twan and Gucci from Jaro City and Von and T.Roy immediately started blowing at them. Gucci was grazed by a bullet to the leg, but Twan, who was only 14 at the time, was taken to Comer Children's in good condition with a gunshot wound right through the leg but could soon leave the hospital. The day after the incident, King Von tweeted, "Who got shot in the leg on roads yesterday?" And when Von later got locked up on November 20th, 2012, Lil Twan even tweeted, "Free King Von leg shooter," and Gucci even tweeted the day it happened, "My damn leg hurt when I got shot at." The next day, Von was even brought in for questioning. Apparently, the police made it known to King Von that they know what he and T.Roy are doing, that they got them both on the radar. However, Von was immediately released and was out on the street again after a few hours. Both T.Roy and King Von followed the motto to the letter. that as long as you do not open your mouth in the interrogation room, you will be released the same day, because usually the police do not have much to go on. T.Roy had now allegedly caught three bodies in just a few months. King Doc, STL/EBT, Dirty Rail, Jaro City, and Modell, STL/EBT, and shot FBG Young, Gucci and Lil Twan. That's three murder cases and three attempted murder cases in only a couple of months. That's more work than most members do during their whole life. It was also two bodies more than what King Bun had, who had caught Doc and Modell. The reason why I mentioned that T.Roy had one more than King Bun is because they seemed to be in some kind of competition about who had the most bodies and attempted murders. On October 29th, 2012, just a day before T.Roy's birthday, King Bun wrote on Twitter, "I ain't been hanging out with T.Roy like that because he's winning. I got to catch up first. Give me to Friday LOL." The next day, on T.Roy's birthday, Vaughn did catch up and probably gave T.Roy the best birthday present by allegedly killing P5 together with J Money, Big A, L.A. Capone and Manny from 600, with 6 shots to his face and 9 shots to his body. T.Roy's name had now started to really irritate Jaro City and STL, and even 051 Young Money, since his name popped up in so many murders and shootings. Now both had allegedly 3 bodies each. And just a week after the murder of P5, they would catch their 4th body and 3rd together, as well as getting revenge for the murder of Sheroid by allegedly killing Bostral from STL/EBT. Both O Block and 600 were desperate to get Bostral after the death of Sheroid, but also after the death of D-Thang, because Bostral was actually there and maybe even put bullets in him. Bostral, whose real name is Rodney Stewart, was killed in the midst of trying to leave both the city and the gang life behind him. He really wanted a way out of it and start over. His plan was to move to Iowa, where he could live with 2 friends and where he had a lead on a job. He bought a ticket for a bus leaving Chicago on November 10, 2012. Rodney Stewart's family and longtime friends say they never expected his life to end this way. They remember him as an easygoing, silly but responsible young man. Stuart was a good kid, who stayed out of trouble. Rodney's grandmother had a conversation with him about a year before he was killed. Stuart warned her that he was in trouble. She didn't believe him. He told me he has enemies and that I wouldn't understand. But truth to be told, Rodney's desire to leave gang life behind did not come from nowhere. He did not just wake up with a change of heart all of a sudden. A few weeks before he was murdered, he had been shot at by a group of OB600 members, and the following week he was shot at twice in the same week, the first time by Big A, and the second time by King Von. Boss Trell basically panicked for his life. He knew they were at his neck because of his involvement in the murder of Sheroyd and D-Thang. Boss Trell was actually really good with guns, except when he almost accidentally shot Spoon in the leg at a bus stop. Boss Trell even uploaded a tutorial on YouTube on how to assemble and reassemble a gun. Arblock and 600 knew about all this, that Boss Trell wanted to find a way out and leave the gang life behind him, 2 days before he was murdered. Boss Trell tweeted, "Can't wait till I get my new start." RB600 figured out that the best way to get rid of him was to set him up, a long way from Parkway Gardens, so as not to arouse any suspicion from Boss Trell. They managed to convince his girlfriend to set him up to meet him on the 2600 block of West 83rd Street, which is about a 20-minute drive away from Parkway Gardens. They made the girl set up the meeting with him the day before. It was not a last-minute call, it was planned in advance. RB600 was well prepared for this hit, and King Von stated that he was the go-to guy for the hits right now, and that he was the captain of the drill team. Neither T.Roy or Von was going to miss this opportunity to get back for their friends, Sheroyd and D-Thang. Now it was time, everything went as planned. The girl managed to set up Boss Trell and OB600 showed up with a car filled with OB600 members. Rondo number 9, T.Roy, J-Money, King Von and Boss Top. They knew exactly where to find him. They spotted him, but as soon Boss Trell saw the car pulling up, he knew something was wrong and started running. J-Money, King Von and T-Roy started chasing him into an alley and the bullets came flying after Boss Trell and eventually hit him, which caused him to fall to the ground. King Von then shot him in the back of his head and T-Roy shot him in his body before they all bailed out. Police found Boss Trell with his face down in the alley shortly after the shooting. They also found a gun under his body. He was taken to Advocate Christ Medical Center in Oak Lawn and was pronounced dead around 11:30 p.m. Thursday, which means that the doctors managed to keep him alive for a long while despite serious injuries. Boss Trell's grandmother also mentioned in an interview that the detectives know who did it, and that the identity of the shooter is not a secret. They just did not have enough proof since no one wanted to witness or cooperate with the police.
Always been in my prayers. And every day is a birthday, a good day for you. I just want to say prayer because, Trell, you know I don't believe in cemeteries. I believe in that. If your faith is strong and we say our prayers and we know that you're going to God, you're going to be with God. I don't come to look down on you. I come to look up to the heavens where I know you are watching over us. So this is my final goodbye to you here.
coming to a cemetery with dead people out. I don't believe that you're dead. Your spirit is alive.
As expected, the disrespect and dissing towards Bostrell and STL/EBT flourished after the murder, especially from T.Roy, J-Money and King Von. T.Roy tweeted things like "No, Trell stay alive," and "Die slow." King Von also took it to Twitter and tweeted, "LOL, you ain't a boss to me," and "Don't worry about who killed who and who got killed. You ain't got killed, did you?" Jakira was totally broken after Bostrell got killed and all of the people who were close to Bostrell. K.I. tweeted, "Browski BT, king of hits, along with Antuka, we gon' make BT name ringing," and Wooski tweeted, "Trying to catch up again. They were really hurt." Oblock was shot up several times the following week after the murder. STL and Jaro were eager to get revenge, and eventually they would get it, though not reconciled a little less than a year later. Just 2 weeks later, it was time again and both King Von and T.Roy caught their fifth body. It's totally crazy how many bodies T.Roy and Von caught together, and it's almost like I do not believe in it myself. However, they always slid together. Both were the captains of the drill team and the go-to guys for the hits. After the murder of Bostrell, King Von made it pretty clear that he was looking for a member of Mob. 5 days before the murder of Lil James, King Von tweeted, "I got the right mind, fire up Mob today," along with "F Mob Boy." So Von was basically at their necks pretty much the whole month, and this was because of Mob shooting at a couple of O-Block members earlier in the month. T.Roy did not say much on Twitter that month. He was mostly mocking Dead 051. Brick Squad and STL members and wrote funny things. In fact, T.Roy did not write incriminating tweets, at least not like King Von. Either way, T.Roy, Von and the other 600 members were out looking for a guy called Lil James, or Baby J, as I told you about earlier. James was an older GD member who many at first believed was a member of Mob because he was shot in Mob territory. Which said he actually claimed is pretty unknown. A lot of people saying that he claimed Damtown, which is the set together with Von World who eventually formed Mob. However, James was from 071 and even called himself Baby Joe 71, which was also his name on Instagram. The set that houses on 68th to 71st, Wentworth to Lafayette is Tay City, who James was really close with, and many members from Tay City attended his funeral, which I will come to later. James was a big trapper and was close with a lot of M-Town and Mob members, which explains why he was in Mob territory when he was killed. A cousin to James even tweeted, "Lost my lil cousin James, because Mogs thought he was in an op neighborhood that was not his own." As I said, James was a big trapper, not a shooter nor a killer. He made huge money from trapping and wasn't shy of showing it off on his open Instagram, where he posted pictures of money, clothes and cars. On November 19, 2012, was the day T.Roy, Vaughn, Blast His Ass and Bite Down decided to go try catch James lacking and rob him. They got a drop on his address where he lived, the 6000 block of South Michigan Avenue. They went to the address and spotted James, but he was not by himself, he was with several other guys. As soon as James and the others saw Bite Down, Vaughn, Blast His Ass and T.Roy, who were all masked up, at least one tried to pull out their guns, but it was too late. T.Roy, Vaughn and the others had all guns on them and had already upped them on the group of people outside of the apartment building. They started blowing bullets at them and James was sadly struck in the right forearm and chest. Luckily, no one else was injured in the shooting. T.Roy, Vaughn and the others bailed out immediately and headed back to 600's territory. James was rushed to Holy Cross Hospital, where he was later tragically pronounced dead. 7 days after the murder, it was time for James' funeral. The funeral got shot up and two people from Tay City were killed, Sherman and Deontay. To my knowledge, Arblock and 600 were not responsible for this, even though they are quite famous for shooting up funerals. The day after the murder, both T.Roy and Vaughn hinted on Twitter about their involvements in the murder of James. King Vaughn tweeted, "I be whacking GDs often," and T.Roy tweeted, "Somebody got shot yesterday." In the incident report from the murder of Lil James, there were four suspects whom the police did not name. However, one suspect had a description that matched King Vaughn's description in the murder report about Malcolm 2 years later. The suspect is described as 5 feet 9 inches tall and weighing 140 pounds. The reason why no names are mentioned, and why I did not get the whole investigation, is because it is an ongoing investigation. Probably because Blast His Ass and Bite Down are still alive. I know that there are several members who match that description, but I do not think it is a coincidence, and it is definitely no coincidence that King Vaughn was arrested the next day and caught a gun charge. Probably much thanks to a tweet he wrote just hours before he was arrested. "I can name 5 GDs I done killed, and 10 I shot." This was a big reason why T.Roy was not arrested, because just like I mentioned earlier, he did not brag about what he had done on the street, at least not to the extent that King Vaughn did. He was very smart in that way. Just like I mentioned, King Vaughn got locked up on November 21, 2012 for a gun and got sentenced to over a year in prison. To T.Roy's despair, He now had to do it without his right hand out in the field. The end of 2012 was also the time when Chief Keef had his big break. He had just released his iconic songs Love Sosa and I Don't Like, and because he had a lot of love for T.Roy, Keef mentioned him in several songs. In December 2012, Keef mentioned T.Roy in the song Savage, where he rapped, "T.Roy got the seven, he'll send yo ass to heaven," and in the song Self he mentioned T.Roy with the famous line, "T.Roy got a gun that's bigger than him, and he gon' blow that all by himself, he don't miss, he gon' leave the right one left." Keef also used to shout out T.Roy on Twitter with tweets like, "Follow O Block Savage or I'm a F.E.O. Mama." Boss Top and also Rondo Number 9 used to mention T.Roy in their songs. It was actually Chief Keef who made T.Roy the infamous shooter he actually became. King Von was not even half as famous around this time. He was known among the gangs in Chicago, but not among the rest of the United States as T.Roy. T.Roy was really loved by everyone. I mean, T.Roy even had fans writing to him on Twitter in 2012. In early 2013, T.Roy hung out a lot with Chief Keef and the rest of Glory Boys like Frito Santana, C-Day, Ball Out, Gapo and Blood Money. He accompanied them to concerts and several events. Because of Boss Top and Chief Keef constantly mentioning T.Roy in their songs, referring to him as a shooter and a killer, made them draw a lot of attention to T.Roy from the police. The police were on his tail daily and sought golden opportunities to lock him up for good. It was the same for D-Rose as well, who was also mentioned in several songs such as Love Sosa. This is actually a very common pattern. The rappers are bringing a lot of heat to the shooters and killers, and there are numerous examples of when members who have been mentioned in songs get locked up. The police want to make examples of them. Just look at C-Day, Rondo Number 9 and now Moo-Wop, but the best example is probably D-Rose. Also, Duke and Moo-Wop were both locked up in 2019 for gun charges after the Get Back Gang era, after being mentioned in songs by King Von. Already in the second month of 2013, T.Roy got into trouble with the law and got locked up for unknown charges. The documents are not public, so it is very difficult to know. However, it did not seem to be anything serious and T.Roy was released again after just 1 week. T.Roy was locked up at the same time as his best friend King Von, but also Trey 5, Bang Man, Bruh Bruh, D-Slick and Lil Boo. Almost immediately when T.Roy was involved in a shootout with Motor and Gucci from Jaro City, no one was injured in the incident. T.Roy was involved in shootings on nearly a daily basis. There is, for example, the classic video when Skinny from Jaro City walked by O Block with other Jaro City members, mocking O Block for not being outside. Just seconds later you hear Skinny say, "Oh, he got the bumper on him," while running in panic as shots from the gates outside of O Block coming towards the group. It was T.Roy who let off shots that day, and this is just one example of a dozen shootouts where T.Roy has been involved in, and this goes for most of the members in most gangs in Chicago. March 2013 was also the time when Dutchie from STL/EBT, who was locked up when one of his best friends, Boss Trell, was shot and killed by T.Roy and King Von, came out of prison and immediately went to Twitter to tweet to T.Roy and about King Von. He tweeted directly to T.Roy and said he wanted to get up with him, and also tweeted, "Free King Von so we can murk him." It was very clear that STL and Jaro were really desperate to get rid of T.Roy before he could drop another body. Dutchie continued to write to T.Roy on Twitter in attempts to link up, and I have heard that it physically ended with they got into a shootout, fortunately without injuries. Dutchie really wanted to get rid of King Von and T.Roy in revenge for the murder of Boss Trell. The summer and the rest of 2013 would be hectic for T.Roy, who put in a lot of work in 2013, allegedly adding three more bodies to his already high count. But it was also a year of three big losses for 600, O'Block and Lamron. 600 and O'Block lost J Money and L.A. Capone in the same month in September 2013, and Lamron later lost Pluto in late November 2013. The reason why I mentioned Pluto and Lamron is because T.Roy was close with several Lamron members, and used to give them shoutouts all the time on Twitter. T.Roy was of course also very close to Lil Durk around this time, who has his origins in Lamron. In the early summer of 2013, T.Roy caught his first body of the year, but not on a set as you might expect. On June 8, 2013, T.Roy caught his sixth alleged body. T.Roy was really on the hunt this summer. In mid-May 2013, T.Roy wrote on Twitter, "If your boyfriend BDK, spend as much time as you can with him, because this summer it's over with him. You better be team no lacking." The fatal shooting occurred early Sunday on June 8, 2013, on Interstate 94, just south of 71st Street, according to police. Three people were traveling southbound in a car. One of them was Stunner from Suwoo DTB, accompanied by one woman and one other man in the car. Suddenly a car appeared next to theirs and started shooting into the car. Stunner was struck with several bullets all over his body. The woman was hit on the stomach, while the third man in the car was left unharmed but traumatized. Both the man and woman were taken to Advocate Christ Medical Center with their wounds. Stunner, 27, whose real name was Frederick Taylor, was sadly pronounced dead in the hospital. Luckily, the woman survived her injuries. The suspected killers behind this murder are rumored to be T.Roy, Boss Money, and BJ from Wick City. I've heard it was T.Roy and Boss Money who shot, while BJ drove the car. Apparently, Boss Money had a personal beef with Stunner, and that was why O'Block killed him and not THF-46 or some of Suwoo DTB's other main enemies. What the beef between Stunner and Boss Money was about is still unknown to the outside world. However, TTB, Nez, and Stunner used to pretty much bully Ocho Money from O'Block, which may have something to do with the matter. TTB, Nez often used to tweet that they caught Ocho and beat him up, and that Ocho even claimed he wasn't O'Block. People often used to save Ocho in situations like these. Kiki from Lamron saved him once, for example. However, sometimes Ocho did not get away. He got caught on the bus once by TTB, Nez, and Stunner, only 2 months before Stunner was killed. TTB Nez even claimed Ocho once said he was only 13, and wasn't claiming O'Block and was now claiming GD. However, I do not know if these things are true nor if it's the reason why Stunner was killed. Boss Money and Ocho was very close. 2 days after the murder, TTB Nez tweeted, "I'm good, F the Wick, RIP Stunner." This is the reason why TTB Nez hated T.Roy and mocked him after his death. TTB Nez also started writing T.Roy on Twitter after the murder with gun emojis and whatnot. Thank you. Just like I mentioned earlier, Su Wu TTB and O Block are not main enemies, and to my knowledge, Stunner is the only body that's been dropped between the two. Su Wu's is heavily affiliated with 051 Young Money and is today part of the Mali Way movement. However, some claim that Su Wu today is basically non-existent. They lost their building, the hood have been gentrified, and a lot of their shorties claim 051 Young Money. Several Su Wu members have also left Chicago and the war behind them. Su Wu TTB is basically famous because of the rapper TTB Nez, who has millions of views on YouTube. He was very close with 051 and even caught a body together with Melly on THF46. Another thing, after the murder, I highly suspect that T.Roy was actually arrested for this murder but later released due to lack of evidence. The reason why I think it's because T.Roy did not tweet for several days. Once he got out, Dutchie from STL tweeted him and wrote, "Bail out next time." I know the reason he did not tweet for several days may sound a little strange, however, it was the same with King Von. He did not tweet for an entire day when he was arrested for the KI murder. Many of these members tweet every single day, so it's not strange to suspect that the days they do not do so are because they have been arrested. However, Dutchie pretty much confirmed it when he wrote, "Bail out next time." Later, you could see T.Roy mocking Stunner in a video where he said, "They will not stunner me, I keep that 33.
You would, they will not stunner me. No, I keep that 33. But this ain't a 33.
Now T.Roy had two more sets coming after him, Su Wu TTB and 051 Young Money. Just a month after the murder of Stunner, T.Roy was went to get caught by Rockhead from 051 Young Money, who started blowing at him. T.Roy luckily managed to escape the situation unharmed. Rockhead later claimed on Twitter that T.Roy ran from him and called him a clown. However, T.Roy denied this on Twitter and wrote to Rockhead that there was no need for running, and asked him if he remembered when C. Murda knocked him out. Even Melly was on that with T.Roy now, and had several interactions with him on Twitter where they mocked each other. T.Roy was also getting shot at by Ario from 051 Young Money around this time. T.Roy was basically chased by O Block and 600's main enemies, Jaro City, STL/EBT and Mob, and now also THF46's main enemies, 051 Young Money and Su Wu TTB, with some of their main hitters out looking for him. Dutchie in particular was after T.Roy because of the murder of Boss Trell. However, 051 Young Money was not looking for T.Roy only because of the murder of Stunner, they were also looking for him because of his constant mocking of Fathead on Twitter and Young Money as a whole. T.Roy could be very disrespectful on Twitter some days. In the beginning of August in 2013, T.Roy had a shootout with Twill and OTHF from 051 Young Money. Because of this, people were really coming after T.Roy from all directions. Many of these members' Twitter accounts are basically a diary of their lives. I have read through all of T.Roy's 13,000 tweets, and all of King Von's 33,000 tweets. There is so much hidden information to be found there. First day in September, T.Roy was locked up yet again for unknown charges and remained locked up for over a week. The day after T.Roy got locked up, O Block took a huge loss when they lost one of their most outstanding and original members, J-Money. J-Money was one of three people in Chicago who were shot dead during Labor Day on the 2nd of September 2013. He was shot dead by Lil B from STL/EBT. Lil B made J Money suffer multiple bullet wounds to his mouth when he was shot dead in broad daylight, the same treatment J Money allegedly gave P5 from Jaro City a year earlier together with King Von, Big A and L.A. Capone. In fact, The murder of J Money occurred only 4 days before P5's birthday, and according to Lil Twan from Tyquin World, Lil B said, "I gave P5 the best birthday gift I could ever have had." Others were tweeting, "FJ Money, RIP P5. An interesting detail I found in the article about J Money was that just hours after the murder, another man was shot to death, a 27-year-old named Frederick, a resident of 63 and King Drive. However, I do not know if the murders are connected, and the name Frederick does not ring any bells in my head. The murder of J Money will be explained more in depth in the story of Lil B." The murder of J Money hit O Block, 600 and the whole 300 very hard. He was close with all sets and was very close to Lil Durk. O Block adopted the nickname Money Gang, or Money Gang, to honor his memory, and you can see several members like Duke, Zell and Mondu of Munna in their name. He has been mentioned in several songs by King Von as well as by other O Block artists. One person he was also mentioned by an incredible amount was the female Savage K.I. as many, including myself, believed to have been on the scene and participated in the murder. However, in J Money's murder report, she is not mentioned as a suspect or present. She may still have been there without being seen, but that she was actively involved in killing J Money seems to be false. But just like I said, she did mock him on Twitter every chance she got. Because of this, she made herself a big target for O Block, who were constantly out looking for her to make an example of her. Good 2 weeks after the murder of J Money, T.Roy and Big A were out walking in the hood, looking for her, and actually catching her, but instead of striking her, they struck an innocent bystander with several bullets. K.I. had blew at Big A twice earlier in the year, and Big A even called her and said he wasn't on that with them anymore. However, when J Money died, who was one of Big A's best friends, he wanted revenge and was especially after K.I. because of all the mocking towards J Money. On September 17th, T.Roy and Big A were on the streets near 61st and King Drive, and really out of nowhere and totally unprepared, they saw K.I. and Cray Cray from STL/EBT at a bus stop. Big A and T.Roy immediately started letting off shots in their direction, but K.I. and Cray Cray somehow managed to escape the bullets that came flying in the air. Sadly, instead of hitting their intended targets, a 67-year-old man was hit several times with bullets to his chest, buttocks and right side. His name was Billy Sargent, and was rushed to the Northwestern Memorial Hospital where he was sadly pronounced dead at 9:15 a.m. The bus stop was left completely bloody and with shattered glass everywhere on the scene. T.Roy and Big A had really made a big mistake. Billy was known for spending his mornings at the corner near 61st and King Drive, sipping coffee with friends and family. All these benches were Bill's benches, said childhood friend Jimmy Ross, gesturing to the wooden seats in each of the nearby bus shelters. "You're going to see him on one of those benches every day of your life." Alan, 49, said he and Sargent were among five men who spent their mornings at one of the corner's bus shelters. Harris said he counted Sargent among his best friends, a father figure with whom he often spoke about sports, politics, the crime going on in the neighborhood. Alan said he planned to return Wednesday to the shelter where the shooting took place. I'm going to put some flowers there and I'm going to cry, he said. The intersection of East 61st Street and South Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Drive, which splits the West Woodlawn and Washington Park neighborhoods, has long been a hot spot for crime, residents said. Ernest Brooks, a retired police officer and one of Sargent's neighbors, said he plans to leave the city. I got a for sale sign around the corner, the longtime area resident said. The gangbangers come up and down here and practice shooting. There is much to suggest that Billy was completely innocent, however, I have heard that he had some connection to Quiet Money. Incidents like these when bystanders are killed are bound to happen because most gang members only shoot with their eyes closed, and without a sense of security for the people around them. I can almost guarantee that most of the top killers in the gang have one or two miscellaneous buddies. For example, it has recently become known that Melly allegedly killed a guy named Lil Ball from DMK from out west, and I can almost guarantee that people like King Von, Lil B and KTS Von also have murders under their belts that we do not know about. After the murder, Jakira tweeted things like F people tried to J money me, F a man a gang, straight up, and, you a shooter, but you shot at me and missed, most likely aimed at T.Roy. Dutchie tweeted things like, shooting innocent people does not amaze me, and, they're savages dying, they hit innocent people over here. One day after the murder, no person had been charged with the murder, however, a person of interest was brought in for questioning by the police just one day after the murder. The person, who according to sources was a 15-year-old boy, was arrested for matching the description of the shooter who was seen running from the scene. However, the teen was later released without being charged after police corroborated his alibi. Another person who was arrested by police the next day was T.Roy, however, it is unknown if it had anything to do with the murder, but there is much to suggest that when he was arrested the next day, it is very possible that T.Roy was also questioned by the police. T.Roy could also very easily match the description of a 15-year-old due to his height. Ocho Mana from O Block tweeted, "Damn, free T.Roy." Edog, who was present when Jay Money was shot to death in front of him, has also been rumored to be present when Billy was shot to death, and he and BJ were also arrested the day after the murder. This was allegedly T.Roy's seventh body in just 2 years. However, before we get to that murder, let me tell you about a murder that took place just a few days earlier, and that is the murder of the rapper L.A. Capone from 600. On September 26th, 600 lost its absolutely most profiled and outstanding members. L.A. Capone was on his way to the top, and I'm sure he would have been on the same level, if not higher, as Lil Durk, if he were alive today. He had such an incredible talent for music and lyrics. However, L.A. Capone was not only a rapper, he was actually an outstanding member in the aspect that he was a killer, and allegedly had a body on Mob and one on Jaro City, and was present at 2 to 3 other murders, so he was a very important member apart from the music and putting 600 on the map. He was killed outside a music studio after Hard Knock from 757 gave away his location to 051 Young Money. Rockhead, Lil Mick, Big A and Mako got on it immediately, waited until L.A. Capone came out of the studio, and then Lil Mick ran up to him and shot him in his right thigh and lower back. He was rushed to the Northwestern Memorial Hospital where he later was pronounced dead. The leg L.A. Capone was shot in was the exact same leg that Boss Trell had shot him in a year before his death, which could be the reason why L.A. Capone never made it. Rockhead, Lil Mick and Mako is all currently locked up for involvement in the murder of L.A. Capone, and Big A was shot and killed by THF-46 a little over a month later. As you all know, this murder took an incredible toll on 600 as a whole, and would have devastating consequences for the gang, but that is for another story. However, both T.Roy and King Bun were very close to L.A. Capone, and the former would later take revenge on 051 Young Money. T.Roy was released just days after allegedly being arrested for the murder of 67-year-old Billy, and just a month after being released, the same thing happened again. T.Roy would allegedly kill an innocent bystander yet again. However, I never found an article on it nor found any victim that day on the Chicago Scanner. The only victim that day was an unnamed male with a gunshot wound to the leg who survived. The alleged murder took place in a similar way as when 67-year-old Billy was shot and killed. However, this time, T.Roy was out in traffic with Boss Top, C-Day and T-600. Somehow they found out the whereabouts of a few STL and Jaro members. Basically, they immediately got on it and slid and came through 63 and Vernon blowing at them. But instead of hitting the STL and Jaro members, they hit an innocent bystander. The day after, Jakira tweeted, "People shot at me and missed, and whacked a clock." Dutchie tweeted, "Once again O Block came through and hit an innocent, a hype clock. These boys are crazy." Jakira indicated that someone was killed while Dutchie only stated someone was shot, which makes the whole thing very unclear. My theory is that Jakira's tweet refers to when T.Roy and Big A allegedly shot and killed Billy in the midst of trying to kill her, while Dutchie is referring to a different incident where a man was shot in the leg on 63 and Vernon. However, I may be wrong, but that theory makes the most sense to me since I did not find any death article on that day, along with the fact that one male was shot in leg on STL's territory, which I think Dutchie refers to. So I'm pretty sure we can dismiss that supposed body. 3 days after the shooting, T.Roy tweeted, "They are scared of me and I'm like 5'3". Not much else happened for the rest of 2013. However, Lamron tragically lost Pluto, which has been mentioned many times by Lil Durk in his songs. T.Roy also paid his respect to him several times on Twitter since he was close to him and the rest of Lamron. Later in December, T.Roy and Boss Sean from O Block ended up in a dispute with Rondo Number 9, or rather misunderstanding. Rondo Number 9 apparently asked Tay Capone if he was a Glock boy now, which is another name for O Block, the same with Stretch Gang. Tay had written that he was an official Glock boy on Twitter, and when Rondo asked Tay about it, T.Roy, Boss Top and Boss Sean thought that Rondo was sneak dissing O Block. T.Roy even tweeted, "Dude sneak dissing the Glock boys, I'm not that." Boss Top tweeted that Tay 600 was an official GBMG member now, which stands for Glock Boys Money Gang. However, Rondo number 9 explained himself on Twitter to Boss Top and T.Roy, and said he did not ask with any intentions to sneak Diso Block, but rather just asked on some 600 stuff. T.Roy also had a dispute with Capo from No Limit once he started beefing with O Block and Lamron. However, T.Roy never really got on that with Capo and even tweeted, "I'll get on that with dude, but that will be like helping the ops." This kind of thing happens all the time, members who start arguing due to misunderstandings, because they think the other person is talking behind their back, and many of them have too much pride to sit down and talk about it, and instead choose to resort to violence and weapons. Now we have come to the year 2014, a very eventful year, not least for T.Roy. It barely took 2 weeks of the new year before T.Roy managed to get locked up again. He was arrested on Stony Island due to an issuance of a warrant and because he drove around with a broken headlight and revoked license. However, I think this arrest was mostly about T.Roy seeming to violate his probation. T.Roy was released 1 month after his arrest, and was released the day before, or on the same day, as King Von was released after serving more than a year in prison for a gun charge. Now both of the O Block top killers were out in the free world again, and they would make 2014 a very scary year for their enemies. Neither King Von nor T.Roy had really had the chance to take revenge for the murders of J Money and L.A. Capone. In 2014 it would come. STL and Jaro were actually scared when King Von and T.Roy came out of jail. Members from that side even referred to King Von as a serial killer, and some people even stayed in the house once both of them were out. They knew that they were both looking for revenge and what a reputation they had, with already having multiple bodies each. Both on STL and Jaro City, people knew that neither T.Roy nor King Von would back down. They would go crazy and put the pressure back on STL. Jaro and 051 Young Money. Once they were released, Boss Top tweeted, "I got my youngins back, I dare someone to get out their body." The only person who really held it down for STL slash EBT, and can even be compared to T.Roy and King Von was Lil B. However, Lil B was killed by police in late March after pulling a gun on them. Only a month after both T.Roy and King Von had been out in the free world, a body was dropped. It was not anyone, it was the man who put 051 Young Money on the map, an outstanding member, not only in terms of rapping but also in the streets. It was the best revenge they could really get for L.A. Capone. On March 25th, 2014, just 3 days before Lil Mark was shot to death, Lil Mark released his most famous and acclaimed song No Competition, which is a remix of Lil Durk's song Competition featuring Lil Reese, where he dissed Brick Squad, Wooing the World and King Lil J. Lil Mark's remix of the song was an even more disrespectful song, in which he mocked several deceased members from 600, Lamron and O Block such as L.A. Capone, Daisky, O.D., Baldy, Trix, Lil Rob and D-Thang. This song was of course a big part of why he was killed. It was no coincidence that he was killed 3 days after the song was released though. Lil Mark was not only a rapper, he was one of 051's top members and was rumored to have killed Stefan from Welch World in 2006, when he was only 12 years old. The song that Lil Mark released got a lot of attention in Chicago, and many got angry and he made himself a big target. Because neither 600, O Block nor THF-46 could kill those responsible for L.A. Capone's death, because they were in prison, and because they never managed to catch either Melly or Kiddo, who were also on top of the list for the BDs, Lil Mark became their highest priority instead. A rapper for a rapper, or as Lil Durk said in the song 1773 Vulture, if we cannot find you, we gon' kill your artist. On March 28, 2014, Lil Mark would tragically suffer the same fate as his brother Tuca, be shot and killed at a bus stop. The question is why Lil Mark was standing there that day, because 2 days before he was close to getting caught at the exact same bus stop, by basically the same people who would catch him exactly 2 days later. That day, Lil Mark escaped with a hair's breadth after King Bun from a block, Twilla and Rome from THF 46 almost put him away for good. 2 days later, Lil Mark sadly did not have the same luck. As I said, 2 days later they sadly caught Lil Mark for real. Mark was standing at a bus stop at 1:27 p.m. on the 300 block of East 51st Street. Some members of Lexville spotted Lil Mark at the bus stop and gave THF 46 the location. THF 46, who was already in traffic with members from Folly Boys, 600 block, immediately got on it and drove to the location and spotted him. The people who were in the car were allegedly Twilla from THF 46, D-Rose from 600, 5-Star from Folly Boys and T.Roy and King Bun from a block. They pulled up next to the bus stop and Twilla allegedly jumped out at the minivan and started shooting at Lil Mark, with the gun equipped with extended mags. Meanwhile, King Von and D-Rose allegedly shot from inside the silver minivan. Lil Mark started running immediately as the van pulled up. The first couple of shots shattered the glass at the bus stop, but the other shots hit Lil Mark in the head. They then sped away from the scene and fled north and then west. The minivan, which actually belonged to D-Rose, was later found in flames about 6:30 p.m. in the 3700 block of South Ellis Avenue. Several shell casings from different guns were recovered on the scene, and a witness to the shooting said he saw one man jumping out of the van and began firing shots at the man who stood at the bus stop.
Ring bells, preview, B12, nigga fuck 12, on a block nigga like it ain't shit, I don't tip nigga, all of my crib, all of my dick and nigga do.
Whose bullets actually hit is impossible to know. All three who have been singled out as the alleged shooters have basically credited themselves with the body. Just hours after the murder, D-Rose tweeted, "I'm going in, ain't gotta ask who shot him," along with, "Marco what I'm smoking on, Marco Pack." King Von tweeted, "Smoke up, now we're back at it," along with a couple of DIY tweets and a tweet indicating that he was one of the people who let off shots. King Von has also mocked Lil Mark several times throughout his rap career, one time where he said, "Caught that boy right by the bus, this is his last stop." Twilla has also mocked Lil Mark multiple times, one of which was when he went back to the location where Lil Mark was killed and posed for a photo. What is even more shocking is that just hours after the murder, D-Rose, D-Roy and King Von went back to the crime scene to film and mock Lil Mark. The body was no longer there, but still, the disrespect had no limits. T-Roy also did not show any respect as expected. Immediately after the murder he tweeted, "Somebody got Tuca on 51st, who was it with a series of laughing emojis?" He also posted the Instagram link to the video where he, King Von and D-Rose returned to the crime scene to mock Lil Mark. T-Roy continued to mock Lil Mark and 051 Young Money the rest of the day and the day after. He even tweeted directly to Rockhead's Twitter account, mocking Lil Mark. Arrow from 051, who T-Roy was good friends with in the past, tweeted, "I do not see how people can sleep." That tweet was later retweeted by T-Roy. The disrespect after this murder is the most I have seen from T-Roy after a murder he was allegedly involved with. The very next day, another body was dropped from the GD side, one of STL/EBT's most outstanding members, Lil B. However, he was not killed by any gang member but was shot dead by police after allegedly pulling a gun on them. According to Motor from Jaro City, Lil B had been shooting up O Block that morning before he was killed. Just over a week later, Chief Keef's cousin Blood Money from Front Street was killed, allegedly by Scrap and Bebe from Mob, and K.I. from STL/EBT. K.I., who was rumored to be one of the alleged shooters, which FBG Butter later confirmed after her death along with a couple of other murders, was totally heartbroken after one of her best friends Race and Lil B. Shaw was murdered by the police. She was angry and was ready to catch another body, whether it was someone from TYMB, O Block, 600 or even a police officer. She really did not care. It all ended up with her, Scrap and Bebe from Mob catching Blood Money. Just 2 days after the murder of Blood Money, one of his alleged killers, Jakira, was killed. I have previously mentioned that T-Roy was in the car, and maybe even shot Jack Riot during the hit. However, after the police report came out where King Von was mentioned as the sole shooter, I doubt that T-Roy was actually there. However, it was not the reason that T-Roy was supposedly locked up, because he was not. He turned himself in an hour or so after the murder. He may still have been present in the car with Boss Money and Big A, however, it is difficult to know. Regardless, I've already told you about her murder multiple times. I was even the first to put out the story of King Bun and K.I. 2 years ago on my channel before this one, ChiUSA77. You can learn about the murder of Jakira in the story of King Von Part 3.
them stocking y'all ass. Shut your sister got money
so dirty. Y'all living off the
you lie, bro.
They creating this. That bitch wasn't no assassin. That bitch got smoked.
Oh, too, she was tough. She acted blood money.
How many times she got
hit? Acted blood money. Ask OD.
How many times she
ask
got hit?
Ask Rod. Ask Mature. Ask Joey.
Your ass a fucking
oh,
goofy,
I keep
man.
Naming, so. Them bitches
you see
love
what's going on?
Fool them.
Read the comment. Butter number 12.
Right now, man.
I'm gonna go get some more.
This is my daughter right here. This is my daughter, Kyra. This is my daughter.
He said my daughter,
Kyra. This is my daughter, nah. She kissed daughter, nah. My daughter, Kyra. Hey, Kyra, hey.
Just as I mentioned, T.Roy was arrested shortly after the murder of Jakira. It is unclear why he was actually arrested. Some also believe that he turned himself in for some reason. In jail, he apparently got beaten up by Nino from Brick Squad, and ended up in several other fights. People were really after him because of the dirt he did in the free world. King Von made several Instagram and Twitter posts saying free T.Roy, and said he could not wait for him to touch back down. However, in June 2014, T.Roy was reunited with King Von when Von was arrested for the murder of Malcolm and the two attempted murders. It bothers me a little that I do not know what T.Roy was locked up for. I suspect that he again violated some policy for past cases and had to serve the time he had left. However, after a little more than 3 months, on July 16th, T.Roy was released and returned to the free world. However, he was not entirely free since he was put on house arrest for over a month. In the summer of 2014 was also when the beef between Glory Boys and O'Block really started to spark up, with Boss Top taking Chief Keef's chain, and OJ taking Capo's chain. For the most part, T.Roy stayed out of the beef, but Capo continued to sneak dissing T.Roy with Instagram posts where he posted pictures with Glory Boys with T.Roy in them, with the text, "Someone here do not belong there." T.Roy responded to Capo with the tweet, "I'll be with the person that took your chain, the one you hiding from," Lamron OJ with laughing emojis. Capo and T.Roy never really got on that with each other. O'Block could not go to war with No Limit, and No Limit could not go to war with O'Block, Lamron and THF46. There is just too much ties between the gangs, not least in the music industry. But it was very close that things started to pop off for real, very close. In late July 2014, T.Roy was nearly caught lacking by Freaky from Brick Squad. Apparently Freaky and one other Brick Squad member were waiting outside T.Roy's end house, and started blowing once T.Roy came out. However, T.Roy had his pole on him and upped it on their car and the offenders sped away from the scene. Everyone was out for T.Roy. While King Von was locked up, T.Roy tried to do everything to get him out. He robbed several people in an attempt to get bond money to get out his best friend. He really showed his loyalty to Von. You could not separate them. It did not happen much more the rest of 2014, and we are now actually starting to come towards the end of the story. Next year, April 14th, 2015 to be exact, T.Roy was locked up and got charged with unlawful use of a weapon along with a couple of other charges. This time T.Roy had to serve some real time in jail for the first time. He was not actually released until over a year later at the end of July 2016. Once T.Roy came out, many were very desperate to get rid of him for good, and many shorties who had been afraid of him before, now took on the task of killing him themselves. When T.Roy was locked up, Many shorties such as DB, Twan, Poppy and other Tyquin World shorties were put in a lot of work. So when T.Roy came out, they were really looking for him. However, FBG Duck actually took the risk himself and tried to pop T.Roy when he shot him in his hand, and at that point Duck was famous and successful. It shows how much they want to get rid of T.Roy. During T.Roy's last months alive, he was almost exactly the same T.Roy as in 2014. He did not catch any bodies and was not lurking as much anymore. However, he was still on that and was involved in shootings. However, I think T.Roy knew his time was coming. Damn near every member from the other side was out to get him. T.Roy had also formed a family around this time, which meant that he spent more time with them than on the street. On Valentine's Day, February 14, 2017, T.Roy's life would sadly come to an end, and TB, who allegedly caught his fifth body, pretty much got his death warrant. T.Roy was walking in the 2000 block of East 71st Street in the South Shore area, allegedly looking for TB. TB had several pictures of him standing on the exact street and especially outside a sports shop on that street. That day, T.Roy was out by himself looking for TB and decided to go to the street where he had seen pictures of DB to see if he was there. It is then rumored to have been Brick from STL/EBT, who spotted him and called TB to give him T.Roy's location. It was no wonder that it was Brick who spotted T.Roy, because Brick, just like DB, lived in Paxtown around that time. When TB got the call, he picked up two times and can't get right and went to the location. But T.Roy, who was on full alert since he was lurking, spotted them and upped his gun on them and tried to chase them down. DB and the others ran and got away and went to their apartment, grabbed guns and dressed up completely black. They went back to the location and spotted T.Roy going into a grocery store on that street. DB along with Can't Get Right went inside the store. On the surveillance footage you can even see T.Roy standing next to Can't Get Right and TB. Second later, DB upped his gun and shot T.Roy once in the chest. Both DB and CGR rushed out of the store and fled the scene. The police knew exactly who it was who shot T.Roy due to surveillance footage and witnesses, but somehow, DB never managed to get charged with the murder despite all the evidence the police had. The whole hit went down like a cat and rat game. First T.Roy was out looking for DB. Brick spotted T.Roy and called DB who came with CGR and two times, T.Roy spotted them and tried to chase them down. They got away and went back to their apartment and went back to the location with loaded weapons, dressed in all black and shot T.Roy. DB and the others were actually close to abandoning the mission. It was a huge risk. T.Roy was on full alert and it could have ended up the other way around, but it didn't. T.Roy, 23, whose real name was James Johnson, was taken to Northwestern Memorial Hospital in critical condition with a gunshot wound to the chest and was later sadly pronounced dead.
Damn, they on here talking about what you think about T.Roy getting popped. Damn, T.Roy got popped?
Why do you think
this
happened,
though? When did that happen?
Why you
got to live,
car?
When did T.Roy get popped? Hey. Damn, somebody popped him. Is he dead? Is he dead? Did he die? Damn, Merch, did they pop T.Roy? It must don't be, it must ain't that important shit. It ain't all over the internet. I ain't see shit. He must not be dead.
You know, I mean, I'm gonna figure this shit out. It'd be cool out there. I call folks. It's like, this on like Valentine's Day, you see what I'm saying? I call folks and shit, I'm calling. I call my mama. My mama call. We try to call T.Roy, she ain't answer. Yeah, we try to call T.Roy, she ain't answer. I went. Nah. What I do? I call somebody, I probably call a hoe or something. I call a Zarius, so I call a bitch or something, I call a hoe. Then, wham, I call my mama back. And she crying and shit. I'm all, what the fuck? What you crying for? You good? You know what I'm saying? She, ooh, they shot T.Roy. T.Roy got, now what? Ooh, what? Look at the phone. You know how that shit go? You in jail? You can tell. Hold on, what? All right. Now we calling. Right? What's going on? He got hit once. Some shit. Damn. What the fuck going on out there? I'm T.Roy, got shot. Look, this is the thing, y'all don't know T.Roy. Y'all got to leave our history of T.Roy, y'all don't know. T.Roy got the girl for the, that's T.Roy. Oh, you know what I'm saying? Y'all don't know T.Roy like I know T.Roy, you know what I'm saying? So when I hear he get shot, I'm, the fuck he? He don't want to tell me, like, don't be lacking, don't be, you know? He was on me, he used to be on each other, you know what I'm saying? Because me and him, we back to back with my boy, you know what I'm saying? Folks got shot, I said, hold on. I said, the streets, hold on. Who got shot, who? Nah, my, he a gangster, he got shot before, he a gangster. I said, folks ain't make it on front of mouth. I play it out, you know, you gotta play it out. You in jail, so all type of goofy ass niggas around, you know, these niggas thirsty, these niggas. All of your business, okay, ain't they, I walk it off. That's it, you know. Now my homie from out west, I fuck some niggas out west, Willie D and them, and nigga Junior on phone. Now I fuck with them niggas hard, okay? That's the same gang. Now they see me, I'm just walking around in circles on the deck, you know. And they put their arm around me when I'm like, damn, you good, little bro? You good? What's wrong with you, Vaughn? Yeah, I'm good. Ooh, what's wrong? You just got a phone, man. I'm good, you know. Hey, what happened? I mean, they just killed T.Roy. Ooh, he what? Hey, I'm T.Roy. They just killed T.Roy. Oh, I gotta break it down on King Dave, that shit. I couldn't help it. They hug me. These some real niggas. You something me grown ass men. Folks grab me to hold me and shit. You get to there, you gonna be all right, shorty. You gonna be all right. Oh, hold on, boy. That's my best friend, boy. They just killed my best friend while I'm in jail. I'm in that bitch, don't know what's going on. The fuck is y'all? I'm that bitch, getting that. Nah, not my best friend, you know what I'm saying. I'm in that bitch, getting that. The B get got. Ain't a lot of hope for a lot of niggas, cause he be. Y'all know how folks is, man. Niggas know T.Roy. Oh, niggas know T.Roy. Oh, let me see. Oh, yeah. The guys know. The guys just looking like, ooh, this nigga preaching on. Oh, don't trip, you know.
After the murder of T.Roy, Oblock adopted the nickname Get Back Gang. The rest is history.